My name is István, and I come from Budapest. I live in Budapest, here in an estate called Wekerle. I'm an English teacher and an activist. This is an estate that is 1 kilometer by 1 kilometer. If you look at it from space, it looks like a big square. This whole place was constructed and built 100 years ago. The planning of the place was influenced by the Garden City movement, and it happened so because a lot of people at that time moved into the city from the countryside, and the state wanted to provide flats and living spaces to them that were similar to their living spaces in the countryside. So they wanted to create a housing estate which is similar to the village, where you live close to nature, you can grow your own food, and you have all the necessities and the necessary services at a short distance. This was 100 years ago, which means that it was planned and built before the two world wars. And there's a proverbial saying in Wekerle, in Budapest as well, that if the two world wars hadn't happened, then all of Budapest would look like this, which sounds very nice. It's green because they wanted to make it similar to the lifestyle that people have in the country when they live close to nature. And streets are really wide. You don't only have the pavement and the road, but you have a very wide green belt, a green strip between the two. And they planted different kinds of trees on different streets. That's why it's so green. It really is cooler, and the air is fresher here at the moment than in other parts of the city, because there's more green. And when they started all this, they also planted 4 fruit trees for every flat. There was also a service, a free service from the city to help people, you know, look after their trees, treat their trees. And they also planted fruit bushes along the fences of the houses and the gardens. And there was 1 year when there was so much red currant that people could sell them and make enough money to pay their rent for the flat. So the original plan of the builders of the place came true. But since then, lifestyle of people has also changed. So there's less people growing their own vegetables, and there's less people working within the area, and there's a lot of people living here but traveling to the city to work, and they buy their food in the supermarket or slightly better at the market, so they don't grow so much of their own food. But we are trying to reintroduce these original basic principles for all sorts of different reasons, for self-reliance, for fighting against climate change and all that. So the original idea is still living here, and you have the setting, you have the greenery, but you have to reintroduce a few things to people's minds as well. There's an organization here called the Wekerle, which is the name of the place, the Wekerle Partnership Alliance or something like that, which is basically an NGO that looks after the historical and the architectural heritage of the place, and they organize local community events like sports days and all kinds of things, you know, weekends for families, and you can meet people there, and people come together and talk to each other and get to know each other. And also, since you have a lot of local services, like you have a local language schools, and you have schools where you can go to do sports in the afternoon, and there's a local pub and a local cake shop. You tend to meet people, and people know each other here, more like in other places maybe. Climate change, and you have peak oil, energy is more scarce now, it's more expensive, and we are, you know, damaging the climate. So living a more ecological lifestyle would be healthy, and this is an ideal place for that, because in other places you can't really grow your own food if you live in a block of flats. But here you have the opportunity. There's a movement in Britain called the Transition Towns Movement, who are trying to prepare for the challenge of peak oil, when oil becomes too expensive to base your lifestyle on, and we are preparing to adapt to climate change. And we are trying to do something like that here, you know, get people thinking about their options, where their energy comes from, where the food comes from, how they travel, and try to get them to live a more ecological life. So 1 year ago or 2 years ago, I was thinking how bad things could get if climate change goes on, and what could really happen if it really hits us. And when I went to the climate camp in London last year, I realized that it's already happening, and it's already affecting people in a really bad way. I'm just too lucky to have realized that, because I live in a nice place. I think future... So there are many scenarios for the future. It could turn really bad here as well. Like, the economy could collapse, and we could have an oil crash, and there would be no food in the supermarket, and it would really go crazy here. Or maybe things will go on like this for 10, 15 years, while things go really, really bad in other places, in Hungary or on the planet. So saying that, well, in the near future, things might get really worse is really a privileged position, because it is getting really, really bad in other parts of the world, especially for poor people. We are kind of rich people living in a privileged position. But I don't know if it will change.